What's up, y'all? Welcome back to another video. It's Lydia. Thanks for tuning in. And if you're new here, be sure to subscribe. I will love you if you do. And hit that bell button too to be a part of the notification crew and notification squad. Y'all know the drill. Comment down below. Let me know you're here so I can reply to you and show you some love down in the comments. But let's just jump right into the video for today. So I'm going to be doing a one product wash and go review demo situation with the Aunt Jackie's Coconut Cream Recipes Curl Boss Coconut Curling Jelly. Well, that was a mouthful. But yeah, so I actually got this product sent to me by Aunt Jackie's. In no way is this going to be like a sponsor video or a video that I'm just gonna, you know, BS and lie and rave about just because they sent it to me. I really do appreciate the fact that Aunt Jackie's did send this to me. They actually watched my video that I did a couple weeks back with their Don't Shrink Gel, and someone actually reached out to me in my Instagram and was like, oh, that gel is actually supposed to be more for repairing your hair, which my hair really didn't need it, and she recommended that I try this, and they actually sent it to me. So I'm super appreciative that they were willing to send it to me. I'm still gonna be completely honest with my thoughts and everything. I've never tried this gel before, but I know it's super affordable. I don't think it's any more than like $8 at Target or something like that, so that's one thing that I will give them a thumbs up for, that their products aren't crazy expensive. But yeah, so now that we know what product we're going to be reviewing, let's get into the details. And if you're not into all of the details and the claims of this gel and you just want to see how it applies to my hair, I'll put a little timestamp and you guys can just skip to that part of the video. So it says, show curls, coils, and waves who's in charge. This lightweight frizz control jelly recipe uses just the right amount of coconut oil to help deliver impressive definition, shine, and softness without a stiff, tacky feel, and it helps minimize shrinkage. So that's some pretty big claims. So it's supposed to define my curls, make them soft, it's lightweight, and it isn't supposed to feel super stiff or tacky. And hopefully, it's not saying that it will elongate my curls, but it is saying that it will like minimize the amount of shrinkage that I have. So I'm really curious to see how that all works. In terms of the smell, this does have a very strong coconut scent. It's really kind of taking me back to like the Shea Moisture Coconut and Hibiscus line, and you guys know I'm personally not the biggest fan of how that line smells. So no, this isn't my favorite scent in the world. It's not gonna stop me from using it. I'm obviously still gonna try it out and see how well it works in my hair, but it's definitely not my favorite. I'm just not a huge fan of how coconut smells, but that's just me. And then in terms of the directions, it says, best applied to wet or slightly damp hair. Depending on hair's length and texture, apply a moderate amount throughout hair from roots to ends, using more for thicker or longer hair. Evenly distribute by raking through with fingers, style as desired. Okay, so basically the directions are kind of how I would normally put in the product in my hair, so that's good to know. Oh, and one more thing, it does say on the other side, it's great for 1B to 4C textures, wash and go styles, and any curly style in need for long lasting definition. So I think the biggest claim for this is that it should really define my curls, and hopefully not make them too sticky and too stiff or too frizzy. So yeah, we'll just have to wait and see how well it works. Now I'm just gonna take out my hair, section it off. You know me, normally I start in the back of my hair and work my way to the top, and then we'll get to go in with this review. So I'm just spraying this section right here with just some plain old water, and now that the section is nice and wet, I'm gonna go in with some of the jelly. And in terms of the consistency, it does have like kind of a thicker, it feels moisturizing. I wouldn't say it's a super stretchy or it doesn't feel like a super heavy gel, but we'll just have to wait and see. But I'm gonna go in with maybe like a quarter sized amount, a nickel to a quarter sized amount, and then just smooth it in my hair like this. All right, I would say so far so good. The glycerin is making it nice and easy to kind of just slip through my hair. Then I'm just gonna rake it, and then I'm gonna smooth it over just like this. And right away, I noticed that it's clumping my curls together, which I really, really like. That's kind of like the biggest thing if I can tell if a product's gonna work for my hair, is how well it will clump my curls together, just because I feel like whenever my curls are clumped together properly, they will be more defined and they'll last a lot longer. So far, so good with this side. Now I'm gonna go ahead and wet this side real quick. And right away, I think I'm really happy with how my curls are turning out so far. I obviously have to do the rest of my hair and see how my curls turn out. But I will say another thing is that even though this does have that like coconut scent that I'm not too crazy about, it isn't too overpowering, which is kind of good. I'd be kind of annoyed if it was like that super strong, overbearing scent like the Shea Moisture one is, and yeah, that would have definitely turned me off a lot, but so far it's not too overbearing. It's not like taking over the entire room, but now I'm just gonna go ahead and do the rest of my hair. Comment down below if you guys think that my curls are gonna turn out good or bad. Don't skip and forward to the end. I wanna know what you guys are thinking right now. And then yeah, I'm gonna just do the rest of my hair and I will check in with you guys if I notice anything weird or funky going on. So I just finished doing my hair and this is what we're working with. I mean if I scoot up a little bit closer, I think my curls look pretty good as of right now. I'm pretty content, pretty satisfied. Now I'm just gonna have to wait for it to dry and see how it actually turns out, because obviously this phase can look a lot different from like the dry phase. And one thing that I will let you guys know is that I wouldn't recommend going outside if it's super humid with this gel, especially while it's drying, just because this product has a lot of glycerin in it. Glycerin is the second ingredient, and usually humidity and glycerin do not pair well together. So yeah, me, I'm just gonna let my hair air dry inside. I'm gonna stay inside pretty much for a majority of the day. I don't think I have any plans to go outside today. It's Sunday, I'm chilling. Today is just like a wash and go day for me. But yeah, I'm gonna let my hair dry, do its thing, and then I will check in with y'all later. Okay, so it is day two and I wanted to hop on camera and show you guys what my curls are looking like. I actually just got home from work and this is what my curls have looked like after a full day, and I must say I'm pretty satisfied. One, because my curls feel so soft. They feel moisturized and soft, but they're still super defined. Usually when I have like a soft hold gel, my curls end up getting really, really frizzy, but I don't find that to be the case with this gel at all. My curls haven't flaked at all, which is really, really nice, and I don't see it flaking as the days go on, just because there's really no excess buildup. My curls don't feel weighed down and there's no cast. So usually when I don't have those things, I don't really have to deal with flaking, so that's just another thing. And another plus is that obnoxious coconut smell is just not there. I know some people may be bummed out because if you love this smell you want it to linger, but for me, I told y'all I don't like the way this gel smells, so I'm happy that it doesn't linger on day two. But all in all, if I just like sum up all my thoughts and everything on this gel, it's bomb, it's fire, I like it, it's good. Would I recommend it to you all? Yes. Would I buy it again? Honestly, I would. I know this product was sent to me, but I honestly will buy this again for the sole fact that it works. It's so affordable. It's literally less than $10. You can find it at Target. You could probably find it at other drugstores too, which means it's really accessible. You don't always have to buy it online and pay shipping and things like that. And honestly, my results are just so freaking good. Like, my curls are nice and defined and elongated and soft. Like, what more could I ask for? And yeah, if I'm being completely transparent and honest with y'all, like no BS, this gel is worlds better than the Don't Shrink gel that's a part of their flaxseed collection. I do like the flaxseed collection scent a lot more than this one. Like, I don't know what it is. I don't think I'll never be a fan of like super strong coconutty scents, but I know there's people out there who love it. But yeah, this one is a lot better. The only thing that I will note is that since this product does have a lot of glycerin in it, I have to be careful with when I use it. Like, I will never put this product in my hair when it's humid and then just go outside, because my hair will just frizz up. So definitely be mindful of the outside weather before you put this product in your hair. But overall, I'm super happy I tried it out. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and you enjoyed my honest thoughts and review. Let me know if you guys have tried this product out or if you plan on trying it, and be sure to use the hashtag Lydia made me try it if you do, and I'll be sure to repost you on my Instagram and on my Twitter. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. If you made it all the way to the end of this video, comment the word coconut down below, just because This is the coconut curling jelly. Oh, and I'm also doing a 20,000 subscriber giveaway. I recently hit 20,000 subscribers, which is nuts, but I'm doing a huge giveaway because of it, and I have all the details in one of my most recent videos that I posted before this one. I'll link it down below in the description box if you haven't watched it yet. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed, and don't forget to subscribe. I will love you if you do. I won't hate you if you don't, but I would love you if you do. And share this with a friend as well to put them on to this bomb ass product. But yeah, I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.